Good morning, guys. Myself Spurthi. I'm taking for you QABD, that is Quantitative Analysis for Business Decision 2. Already you studied part 1 in the second sem, which is handled by the Anjuma. Part 2 which is handled by myself. The syllabus of QABD is Correlation and Regression Analysis, Time Series, Interpolations and Extrapolation, Sampling and Sampling Distribution, Theory of Probability. As you know, the previous year how you wrote the exam, the same manner will be there. That is, for 2 marks, 7 questions will be there. Out of 7, you have to attend only 5 questions, and 6 marks, 5 questions will be there. In that, you have to attend only 3 questions, and 14 marks, 5 questions will be there. In that, you have to attend only 3 questions. 70 marks, you are writing the exams, and 30 marks, your internal marks. That is based on your behavior. You know all these things. And what are the syllabus you are having for this year? Means for this year you are having, as you know, the languages will be the same. English and Kannada will be there. Instead of Kannada, those who are taking Hindi, they can able to take Hindi, or additional English, some of them they took that also, they can able to continue. And Tamil, Telugu, those who are taken, they can able to continue with that only. One is corporate accounting, that is full of accounting only. Later on you can able to know who is handling which subject. So when you are coming for the college, that time only you can able to know corporate accounting. That will be one teacher only they will handle. Financial accounting, business ethics. So financial accounting is half theory, half practical. Means almost 70% will be the practical, only 30% will be theory will be there. Business ethics, that will be full of theory only. QABD, full of practical only. PRCC, that also theory only. Next is science and society, that is optional subjects, that is core subjects will be there for you. That is foundation course, like foundation course only. That will be handled by Sudhakar sir. Last year you have environment and public health, like that only you are having science and society. Total this sem you are having 8 subjects, including English and Kannada. English and Kannada will be languages, corporate accounting, financial management, business ethics, QABD2, PRCC, and science and society. So now I am taking QABD2. So in this you are having the syllabus. Syllabus is there, correlation and regression analysis. So here in this correlation you have to know meaning and definition, users, types. In types, Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation, probable error, Spearman's rank correlation coefficient, and regression. In that, meaning, users, regression lines, regression equation, correlation coefficient to regression coefficient. So here full of practical only. Next is time series. In time series, introductions, meaning, users, components of time series, fitting a straight line trend by the method of least square, and computation of trend value where sigma x is equal to 0, including graphical presentation of trend value problems. So here you are having graph also. In time series you have to use the graph. Next is interpolation and extrapolation. Here in this, meaning, significant, assumptions, method of interpolation. The method is binomial expansion. Interpolation method, 1 and 2 missing values only. So in binomial expansion, 1 missing value or 2 missing value, that you have to find out. Next is Newton advancing different method problems. The fourth chapter is sampling and sampling distribution. In this chapter you are studying meaning, objectives and types, probability sampling and non-probability sampling techniques, meaning of population, parameter and statistics, sampling distribution, meaning and useful of standard error, simple problems on calculation of sample size. Last is theory of probability, meaning and importance of probability, experiment, event and types of event, additional theory of probability, simple problem and additional theorem only. These are your syllabus. For reference of the textbook, you can able to use Skyward or else 7 lecturers. So most probably you can able to use Skywards only. Or else Himalaya publication Chikkodi, CM Chikkodi will be there. That also you can able to use. So I'm giving for you, if you are purchasing a textbook, you can purchase Skyward. So here it is the meaning. Correlation. The correlation, the first chapter, correlation and regression analysis. Correlation meaning, the correlation is a systematic technique which studies the relationship between the two or more variables. So in correlation, we can able to analyze the statistical analysis or the techniques. We study the relationship between the two or more variables. So when doing the problem, you are based on the two or more variables, you are doing the problem, that is correlation. It is the meaning. Correlation means possible relationship or interdependence among the value of two or more random variables. It describe and indicate the size and direction of the mutual relationship between two or more variables. So it give the relationship, possible relationship between the two or more variables, and it also describe and indicate the size and direction of the mutual relationship, means the two variable mutual relationship, means the same type of relationship between the two or more variables. So here definition will be there. According to Crockston-Cowden, when the relationship in a quantitative nature, the appropriate statistical tools for discovering and measuring the relationship and expression in the brief formula is known as correlation. So based on the formula, we are doing the problems. So based on the formula, we can able to express the relationship between the two or more variables. So in other word, according to A.M. Turtle, correlation is the analysis of the covariation between the two or more variables. So it is a covariations, different variations between the two or more variables. One more definition is that if two or more quantitative vary is sympathy, so that the movement is one tend to be accompanied by corresponding movement other than the are said to be correlated. Means if two or more vary quantitative vary is sympathy, so that the movement in one tend to be accompanied by corresponding movement in the other, they are said to be correlated. So the correlated between the two or more variables, the value will be correlated with the help of the formula. The degree of correlation will be there. Correlation is a systematic device. It means in the formula, we can able to do the problems. With the help of the formula, we can able to analyze the covariations between the two or more variables. So it is the study of interdependence between the variable. So it is the study of dependent variables also. So correlation analysis determine the degree of relationship between the variable. So by the correlation only, we can able to analyze the degree of relationship between the two variables. So relationship correlation may be simple correlation, multiple correlation, or partial correlation. Simple correlation is concerned with the related variation between two related variables. So simply we can able to apply the formula, easily we can able to get the answer for that correlation. So it is only between two related variables. Multiple correlation and partial correlation, which related to the variation among three or more variables. So in multiple correlation, three or more variables are studied simultaneously. In multiple correlation, we are not studying only two variables, we are studying two or more variables. In partial correlation, we recognize more than two variables, but considering only two variables to be influencing each other and the effect of the other influencing variables being kept constant. So in multiple correlation, we are using two or more methods. For example, x, y are the variables. If x and y only considering, that is simple correlation. By applying the formula, we can able to solve the correlations. So if the three value variables will be there, x, y and z. So in multiple correlation, we are using x, y separate, y, z separate and x, z separate correlations. In partial correlation, we are using the T different method, that is x y we are comparing which is the better one. Based on that only we are selecting, only that we are two variables to be influencing each other, only two variables we are selecting which is appropriate and which is proper for the or proper for the correlating to kept the constant. Here it is quotients. Quotients means the solutions. When the variable x and y are correlated, there may be three types relationship. X is caused by and y is effect. X is cause and then y is effect. X is effect and y is cause. X and y are affected for some other reason. Here we can able to use rain and yield. So rain fall more, it will be the cause, and yield of the paddy effect. Means if the rain is more, that will be effect for the growth of the paddy. Price effect and demand cause. Sometimes price, so paddy will be affected, then price will be affected and demand will be the cause. If price will be increasing, means price effect will be there, then the demand, automatically the demand will be increasing. Yield per acre of the rice and T or both effect of rainfall. So per acre the rice and the T, or if both are affected based on the rainfall, then the value of both it will be increased. So quotient means it is a cause and effect relationship between two variables. It is called quotient. Quotient always implies correlation. However, the converse is not true. A high degree of correlation between the two variables need not imply a cause and effect relationship between them. Correlation is absence of caution is a superior or the sense correlation. For example, population of India and the population of Japan is in different year have superiors and correlated, no cautionism. So here the correlation between the two variables, that is we the proper variable will be there, then only they can able to do the correlation. If for example population of India and the population of Japan in different year have a superior correlations, means different correlations will be there. So the Indian population will be more and Japan population is less than the one state. So we cannot able to analyze this correlation because the cause and effect will be very different for this. So in one, in India only we can able to compare between the two states. So we cannot able to compare the level of the correlation will be between the same level only we can able to correlate it. Next class, types of correlation.